Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all ye creatures below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. This is Ambassador L.F. Craig of the Shelter God Safe House and In the Know for New Life. Yes, get in the know today and you can change your every tomorrow. This is Wednesday, December the 2nd, 2020. This is day 3 of our word for the week. And our word for the week is openness. Openness. And we've been talking about openness, unrestricted, revealing, exposure, transparency, accessibility, inclusion, those things that we've been sharing with you. So we're going to get into our chunk and chew for the day on this word for the week, openness. Pray that you are blessed, having a blessed and wonderful week so far. Openness, day number 3. Openness. Openness refers to accessibility of knowledge, technology, and other resources. That means people, everyone has accessibility to. That means everyone has an opportunity to get what they need, whether it's knowledge or technology or whatever the resources are, that there's no barriers, there's no hurdles that you have to jump over and hoops you have to jump through. It's accessible, it's readily available for you, and transparency of action. You know what you have to do in order to get what you need. And the inclusiveness of participation, that all are included. Everyone can participate. You have the right to make that choice. And if you choose to make the choice, you are included because it has been open to you and you know what action you need to do in order to be a part. And sometimes we want inclusion, but we don't want to do the action of transparency of the action that it takes to gain the access or to gain what it is that is being given, Okay. So if I'm giving something and it's open to the public and I tell you to be at a certain location at a certain time, if you don't show up, I didn't exclude you. You chose not to be included. If by chance I tell you and I included you and I wasn't clear on where the location was, then I wouldn't have been transparent or making it accessible where you could get to it. But when it's clearly and God is being clear, he's unfolding mysteries. There was mysteries that was hid in times past, but God now is revealing those things. He's opening up to us that wisdom and knowledge that we may know. He's revealing himself and his plan to us. And we have to be mindful in our new mind of not getting off track, that we are hearing. He that have an ear, let him hear what the Spirit say to the church. So you have to have a listening ear and a seeing eye. You have to be able to see what God is saying, for he is speaking. And we're going to talk today about something, because oftentimes we want to take and just be so spiritual and everything that we don't understand that we are in a human body. Even though we're spiritual, having a natural experience, we do have the traits, our personality traits that are developed over time by inherited traits, our DNA, and that mixes with our conversion to Christianity or whatever we believe. But our belief system began to be built within us at an early age. And this is one of the models that they use to identify the different personality traits or the different personalities or how people behave based on that. And some of you may be familiar with it. And it's been around for a long time, since the 1950s, this theory and this process of being able to determine the personality and based on how a person interact in the social interaction of people. And it says it's called the Big Five. Okay. We're going to talk about openness. We're going to talk about that last. But you have the conscience, the extroverted, or extroversion. You have stable, or in another one, it actually calls this the one that's stable, they call it another name. Neurotism. It has the stable, agreeable. We'll look at that. I had that all lined up. And this is just giving you something where you can go if you want to pull up more information about it. The people that have built on this theory and traits analysis and so where do you fit? Okay, even in your spiritual maturity, where do you fit? Because you're still you. You're a triune. You have a body, you have a soul, and you have a spirit. And within that, you have a mind and a will and desires. And then you have your consciousness. We have a lower level of consciousness, but then when our spirit is quickened, we have God consciousness and a higher consciousness that just goes beyond what we can see and touch and smell, goes beyond what is visibly there. Consciousness. People that have a high degree of consciousness are reliable and prompt. Okay, and so they are conscious of time, they're conscious of commitment, they're conscious of routines and different things. And so they are reliable and dependable. And a lot of us need a certain level of consciousness in order to deal and be in relationship. You need this. And so I don't believe that you're all one of these. I believe there's a balance of all five that makes up the personality. You may be have a higher level in one than you do in the other. But and then they have a test that you can take to see where it is, you know. And then we have a spiritual gifting test. And they use some of the same similar testing techniques to see where your giftings are. And it's based on how you feel and how you see things, what's your view, what is your lens like? And how do you adjust your lens when you're looking at things, your sight, your spiritual sight and your natural sight, okay? Introverts gets their energy from interacting with others. You know, they have to be around people, they're people. While introverts get their energy from within themselves, or they are more, stay to themselves. And I think there's a certain level of both within each individual, because sometimes even those that are most outgoing needs their time of privacy and it includes traits of energetic, talkative, and assertive. Okay. Agreeableness, not a go alonger, not just going along to get along, you know. Now you may have some people that are so strong in that they just agree to everything, but this is not really when you're really balanced. Yes, you don't agree. You're not disagreeable. You may disagree on some things. And one of the things that one of the deacons taught me is that we have to have the right to agree to disagree. Okay. But these individuals are friendly, cooperative, and compassionate. Okay. People with a low agreeableness may be more distant. Okay. And so sometimes people are. So you just have to figure out, you know, being kind, affectionate, and sympathetic. And how do this fit into your spiritual makeup? Okay. Okay, let me now this has to do with the inside, go in your nervous system, neurotic. Okay, sometimes you say, somebody say, oh, that's just neurotic, okay? And so it's sometimes called for emotional stability, you know, your mental health. How is your nervous system? How is your emotional state? How are you feeling? And so what pushes your buttons? What causes you to, you know, go one way or the other? Is it traits include moody and tense? And so people that have a high level of this is often experience emotional instability and negative emotions. Okay. And so, but we all need a certain level of this because it's important. Okay. You can't have just all of one. And so, and the Bible even tells us about that. And even though he talks to us about oneness, at the same time, you can't just be all one. Okay, because one of the things that talk about being many members but one body, okay? And so within your personality, you have to have different characteristics. You have to have different traits that you display and use and you pull from in order to grow, You know, and some areas may be weaker than others or not as developed as others. And so, and you can't be everything, but you ought to have a balance. Your foundation, what is it built on? Your basic personality, what do that really actually look like in Christ Jesus? Okay. We have to be loving. We have to be caring. Okay. Because we're becoming who we are. It's the isness of us. Okay, we're becoming who we are. And that means we're becoming who God already, who God has already declared us to be. And that's the reason why in the theory, the theological theory of open theism, it doesn't work in a spiritual sense because God already sees us as we shall be. And that theory says that's logically inconsistent. Well, it may be logically inconsistent because God doesn't do things that lines up with our logical thinking. Okay. Our level of intelligence does not dictate who God is and what God does and how he operates and the abilities and the strengths that he has and all of the things that I am, that he declares, God declares, I am that I am, okay? And so he is a lot in God. And so we are becoming who we are. We are always becoming, we are always transforming into that being because we're learning as we grow. We're growing as we learn. It's a cycle. And so we just learn these things in our character, in our caring. The more we become, the more we are sure, the more we mature, the one that we stand firmly in God and know that what God has for me is for me, then I can let go of trying to be envious of my brother, jealous of wanting something somebody else have because God has something for me too. And so as we become who we are, okay, because we are not who we are yet. And so that's it. So, and that's just like God, you know, he's Father, Son, and Holy Spirit in functioning in the earth, but it's three in one. We are body, soul, and spirit, three in one, triune. Okay. And so when you get your spiritual man, you have to modify your members, you have to modify the bodies and the desires of the flesh to be satisfied, to be the one on top so that your spirit man can grow, okay? So that you can come into your isness of your higher consciousness and your God consciousness, and that what is spirit, that when you worship God, that is from a spiritual place. It is from a consciousness that's beyond what you can just see and what you can intelligently perceive, your perception, your logical assessment of what is. It takes faith. It takes faith to believe God. He said, he that come to God first of all must believe that he is God. Okay. You got to believe that God is who he is and he has all power. He's all knowing and he's all ever present everywhere. Okay. And that takes faith to believe that, that you got to believe that he is God, that he created everything and he put everything into motion. And that one day Jesus said, he didn't even know one day he's going to call an end to time as we know it. And Jesus, the Son, is going to come back and take us. And that takes us becoming who we are. Beloved does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when we see him, we shall be like him. And so we are ever transforming, we are ever becoming, but we have to come to the place of openness. We have to come to that place of openness to experience, or simply openness. It's a basic personality trait denoting receptivity to new ideas and new experiences. And we have to be able to experience the newness of God. Okay. There's nothing. He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. And there's nothing new under the sun for God. But there's new things and new experiences that we have because every day he say he's faithful. Great is his faithfulness. New mercies day after day. He gives us these new experiences and we have to be open to it. Okay. It is one of the five core personality dimensions that drive behavior. Okay. And so people with high levels of openness are more likely to seek out a variety of experiences, be comfortable with the unfamiliar. You know, some people have to have everything in plan, in order. You do this, if you do that, you do, you know, just like church programs and the order of service. If you don't pray first, then, you know, all, you know, threw me all off. Now you got, you know, and so, but you have to be willing to pay attention to your inner feelings more than those who are less open. Okay. Because sometimes the spirit of moving, we're not paying attention to our inner feelings. They tend to exhibit high levels of curiosity and often enjoy being surprised. Now, you know, some of that other stuff is part of me, but that level of surprise, you know, I don't mind receiving gifts of different things. There's certain surprises I, you know, okay, you know, but I don't mind being surprised, not overly surprised, not shocked. People with low levels of openness prefer familiar routines, people, and ideas. That means that's why in our local churches, we just want our group, our four, and no more, okay? But we have to be open. They are perceived as being closed-minded. And so you have to be open-minded, okay? You have to be open-minded to the things of God that he say, I'm going to show you great and mighty things that you have not seen. And so if the best is yet to come, you're going to have to be open. You're going to have to work on that part because you all of us have that trait, but not as strongly as others. It indicates how open-minded a person is. A person with a high level of openness to experiences in a personality test enjoys trying new things. He said, God said, behold, I would do a new thing. Okay, so he don't want us to be robots. He don't want us to be robots. He don't want us to be computers. And even in a computer, every now and then, you need to clean your hard drive. You need to clean your disk. You need to make room for other stuff. Okay, and it'll tell you low on storage or low disk. You know, you're almost out of room. They are, and this is one of the characteristics that God has and we have to have, imagination. We are imaginative. You have to be able to see in heavenly places the things God has for you. So you really have to have an eye that he's able to do abundantly, exceedingly above all that you ask or think according to the power that worketh in you. What do you really see and what do you think that he's capable of? Because sometimes he's doing some things in your life, but they're not really great because he don't have to do far. He don't have to go far to be above what you asked or even think. Curious, open. And I want God to open doors for me. And I believe that it's going to be a sudden blessing. I just believe it. I'm opening my mind. And that's why I am being consistent with what I believe that God has given me to give. And that is to give his word out to his people. No strings attached. Just give it out. You know. And yes, you know. But God is going to bless me through this. Just like, and I believe that it's going to be a suddenly because it only takes God opening one door, opening up one window and pouring out a blessing that you won't have room to receive. And so do you have an openness for God to bless you? Are you in a position for God to bless you? Are you open-minded if God tell you, hey, I need you to pack up all your stuff and I need you to go to here and I need you to do that now? Are you open-minded to that? Okay, because sometimes we're so earthbound and we're so bound to the things that we have that it's hard for us to let go. it's hard for us. And so you don't have an imagination of even being anywhere else. I know that I look at this animal kingdom now, and it just shows different places all over the world, beautiful lakes and rivers, and you know, a whole lot of things that the world is a wonderful place. Because so many times we just see limited, even when you see tourist places, you only see limited places, limited parts of that country. But God, man, you have, and so you have to have a mind. You have to have a little bit of curiosity. You know, what if I do what God say? You know, what I'm doing right now ain't working. So what if I just take a chance? I'm curious. And if I do this other different thing, okay, because in the openness comes where you know that if you want something different, you have to do something different. Okay, that is our chunk and chew for the day. And so I pray that you are blessed, and I pray that you would just continue to pray for me, and I pray for you, that we lift up each other, that God continues to reveal himself to us. Remember, I am Ambassador L.F. Craig of the Shelter, God's Safe House, and in the know for new life. Get in the know today, and you can change your every tomorrow. Yes, you are empowered to change your life. You are fruited and gifted, and you need to pull your gift out and share it with the world. God has great things that he has planned for your life. And you just have to open up yourself, open up your mind, open up your spirit, listen to the Spirit of God, and let him take you where it is that you was destined to always be. I believe it for myself, and I believe it for you. The end is going to be greater than your past.
Open the eyes. don't have.